handy feature in Photoshop CS5.1 is the ability to have multiple documents open on your canvas at any one time. And from CS4 onwards, Photoshop uses a docked tabs system, which means that you can see all of the tabs of your open documents at the top of your screen. On the right hand side, you'll also notice if you have more than the number of documents that can be seen on the screen at one time, there's a double pointed arrow. And if you click on this, it reveals a menu which will allow you to select any of the documents that you have open. This happens quite often in web design when you might have maybe 10 or 20 or so files open at once, and you might need to select them from a drop-down menu like this. So there are a couple of keyboard shortcuts that allow you to navigate through the tabs of your open images. And one of the quick ways is if you hold down the Command and Tab key, or on a PC, Control and Tab, that will cycle through the tabs to the right. And if you want to go to the left, if you hold down Control Shift and Tab, or Command Shift and Tab on a Mac, and that will cycle through to the left. You can also use the Arrange Documents Layout icon in the Applications tab, the Quick Access menu near the top of your screen. And you'll notice that there are a number of different options. You've got things like 2-up, 3-up, 5-up, and you can open all of your various files in separate windows on your screen, arranged in whichever way you would like. There are a couple of lovely features also in Photoshop from the same menu, the Arrange Documents menu. For example, if we zoom in on one of the images at the moment, it's just going to zoom on that particular image, and if we change the location of the image, if we move the actual position, only that particular image changes. However, as we can see here, there are a couple of similar images of the surfer here in different colors, and if we would like to match the zoom and the positioning of all of the images, we can do that from the drop-down menu. Go to Arrange Document Layout, scroll down to the bottom of the menu, choose Match, Zoom, and Location. It's a very handy tool. If you select that option and we zoom in or zoom out, change the position, it does the exact same thing to all of the open files in our display. We can also customize any of these. So for example, if we go back up to our Arrange Document Layout and choose a 3-up option, which means that we can see three of our images on screen at any one time. We can then click and drag to change any of the arrangements. So if we've got two horizontal graphics and a rectangular graphic at the top, we can put that at the top, and the logo and the nav bar can be underneath it. So we can see everything quite clearly in this layout. Second thing we can look at is the panel groups in a little more detail on the right hand side. If you click a tab, you bring it to the front. So for example, at the top here in the panel, the color panel is selected by default, but the swatch tab to the right, if we click on that, it brings that to the front. It's fairly self-explanatory, but it just bears looking at in a little more detail. There's also a double pointed arrow at the top, which means that you can reduce the panels to icons if you want to make them smaller. And you can drag those icons to the right to make them even smaller again if you want to take up less space in your workspace. You can close a panel from the panel menu icon, which you'll notice on the right hand side of all of the panels, which gives you a list of options to choose from a drop down menu. And these are controls for whichever panel you happen to be looking at. For example, if we look at the adjustment panel, we can open the panel, go to Windows, and add an adjustment menu here. And we can also close various panels in this way. If you go to the panel menu, at the bottom is an option called Close Tab Group. If you select that, it means that that particular panel will close altogether. You can collapse or expand panel tabs by clicking in the blank area at the top of the panel. This means you can take up more or less space depending on what you happen to be using at a particular moment. You can reorder the group, so it's very customizable. All you have to do to change the order of your panels is click and drag the top of your specific panel and drag it to where you would like it to be to change the order. So for example, we could have the color panel at the bottom and the layer panel at the top just by clicking and dragging and switching those around. If we grab a tab out of a panel, we can click and drag that. We can switch the tabs between different panels. So if we had the layers tab and we wanted to mix that with the colors, for example, we could just click and drag the tab, transfer it over to a different tab group, and it will automatically join. We can grab any new tab and join it with any other, which is all of this is completely customizable. So basically, you have complete control over the panels, the tabs, the positions, how much space they take up on the screen, and so on. So, for example, a panel or a tab that would be used quite often in web design in Photoshop is the Layer Comps tab, but this isn't there by default. So if we go to the Window menu at the top of the screen and choose Layer Comps, we can open up that tab and then join it with the bottom of the Layers tab at the bottom. We can turn those into icons, we can dock them into a third panel and basically customize it to suit ourselves. If we decide that we aren't quite sure that the layout we've created is the most useful for our needs, we can always go back to the default settings. If you click on the Essentials tab at the top of your screen, it will bring you right back to the default settings of all the panels and the layouts. There's no one particular layout that is perfect for the web because of the nature of web design. It depends what specific aspect you happen to be working on at a particular moment, which panels you may need. For example, you might be looking at typography one day, you might be looking at image editing, you might be looking at layout. It depends what you're working on, and the beauty of Photoshop is that you can customize your workflow and your workspace to suit your particular needs.